In today's video, we discuss a few of the ways a medical practice can be affected by choosing to opt out of Medicare. As you probably know, Medicare rules are complex and are comprised not only of statutes and regulations, but also other guidance such as really thick manuals and other documents from the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services, or CMS. So it's no surprise that our clients have asked us a lot of questions over the years about the decision to opt out of Medicare. I'm Michael H. Cohen, founding attorney of the Cohen Healthcare Law Group. We've advised over 1,000 healthcare industry clients on healthcare and FDA legal issues and compliance issues. Today, I'm going to discuss some of the few most common questions that our clients have asked us related to the Medicare opt-out process and decision. By the end of this video, you'll know what some of the specific conditions that practice opting out of Medicare can expect to face. The first question we'll answer is, as an opt-out physician, will I be able to order labs from labs that bill Medicare? Physicians who opt out of Medicare can generally order Medicare-covered services furnished by a Medicare-enrolled provider, so long as the services are medically necessary services and the Medicare contractor has your required information. Specifically, the Medicare Benefit Policy Manual, which provides advice to Medicare contractors who process claims for the Medicare program, states the following in regard to opt-out physicians ordering services from a Medicare provider that has not opted out of Medicare. Quote, if claims are submitted for any items or services ordered or prescribed by an opt-out physician or practitioner under Section 1802 of the Act, the Medicare contractor may pay for medically necessary services of the furnishing entity, provided the furnishing entity is not also a physician or practitioner that has opted out of the Medicare program. I'm so glad that comma was there because I could take a breath. That was great. So the answer to the first question is normally yes. Another common question is, can I accept cash payments from Medicare patients while waiting for my opt-out decision to take effect? That's a great question. You should not accept cash payments until your Medicare participation effectively terminates, which is at the beginning of the calendar quarter in which you select to opt out. This is also assuming you've timely filed your opt-out affidavit with your Medicare contractor. A participating physician may properly opt out of Medicare at the beginning of any calendar quarter, provided the opt-out affidavit is submitted to the participating physician's Medicare contractor at least 30 days before the beginning of the selected calendar quarter. However, once you enter into your first private contract with Medicare beneficiaries, you then have 10 days to file your opt-out affidavit with your Medicare contractor. This is because the Medicare opt-out affidavit, quote, must be filed with all Medicare contractors who have jurisdiction over the claims the physician slash non-physician practitioner as defined in Medicare. Otherwise, would have filed with Medicare and must be filed no later than 10 days after entering into the first private contract to which the affidavit applies. No comma there, but my breaths are getting longer. So, we might advise a client who plans to opt out of Medicare to enter into their first private contracts with their Medicare patients at least 30 days in advance of the calendar quarter in which they select to start their opt-out period and then file their opt-out affidavit with the Medicare contractor within 10 days of entering those contracts. The last common question we're covering in this video is, what notification or other obligation do I have to my existing Medicare patients? We generally advise clients who decide to opt out of Medicare to inform patients regarding the physician's opt-out status in a form separate and apart from the private contract. You should provide this opt-out status information once you receive confirmation from the Medicare contractor. Here's an example of the sample language we suggested to one of our clients for this purpose. And this is taken straight from the Medicare materials. Physician has opted out of Medicare, provides services to Medicare patients under a private agreement. Medicare will not be billed for those services, and the patient is responsible for the entire fee charged by the physician. Physician fees are not subject to Medicare limits, and Medigap will not pay for those services. The patient has had opportunity to use another physician who has not opted out, but has freely chosen the physician. Thanks for watching. You know, Medicare can be such a complicated topic that there are lots of questions we didn't address in this video. And if your question is one of those, you can click on the link below, cohenhealthcarelaw.com/contact, to send us a message or book an appointment. Here's to the success of your healthcare venture. We look forward to speaking with you soon.